My name is Robert Morton, and I work in the lab of Eve Brun at Indiana University here at IU Bloomington. I've always been interested in the sciences. I didn't always know what type of science I was interested in, but even as a young child, I was always asking questions of my teachers, of my parents, and just anything that aroused my curiosity. I had no hesitation about trying to learn more about it. The older I got, the more interested I got into any science class that I ended up getting put into. And I still didn't quite understand everything, but it was constantly drawing me in. It was constantly making me want to learn more. Some of the future applications of my research. So I'm studying orphan hybrid histidine kinases. So most signaling proteins that students will learn about while studying biology in their undergraduate are histidine kinases and response regulators. Typically these proteins come one after another in the genomic context of the organism. However, an orphan signaling protein usually is unknown in function because it's very difficult to find its cognate response regulators. So that is, it's difficult to find what is downstream of an orphan histidine kinase. I'm working on one which is an orphan, and hopefully my research will further that ability for future scientists to be able to connect these pathways, where it's not so easy to figure out what it is they're doing based off their genomic location relative to each other. So all of my work, when finished, will help future scientists who are studying signaling proteins. So once we've sealed our pad, we take it into the microscope, we can go and we have a variety of different microscopes. All of them involve you focusing the light on the plane where the cells are present. And since we made sure that our auger is in a flat, it's a completely flat plane, all the cells will be on the same level. Once we focused on the cells, we can tell the computer to take a picture, you know, anywhere from every 30 seconds to every 10 hours or any increment in between. For cell growth, Colobacter takes 2 hours to divide, so normally we'd like to do either 5 or 10 minute picture intervals. And you set different positions, the scope will move to the different positions, and it'll take a picture every 5 minutes, let's say. After a few hours, you come back and you play the movie, and you have frames of your bacteria growing, and every frame is a 5 minute jump, and so you can watch them grow and divide and 10 seconds, even though the movie was taken over a span of, you know, 6 hours or something like that. I really love microscopes. I love being able to look at these really small organisms that are everywhere, and they can do some really complex, really amazing things, and you never see them with the naked eye. Like, most people never even think about it except for the fact that, oh, there's bacteria and I need to wash my hands. But these bacteria can do some amazing things, and we can videotape it, we can manipulate it, we can trigger it. People use bacteria to produce things for us. There's just so much potential in them, and I feel like they're overlooked but beautiful.